Friends, and where we bring you the highlights and lowlights from the busiest red carpet in town at the Academy Awards. So let's just get to it. Bring it on, Hollywood. I can't stand it. I'm so excited.
Your mother, she really created the ultimate legacy in my eyes, you know, especially with E, right? Have you ever grappled with trying to live up to her comedic, over-the-top, rebellious, lewd at times, tell it like it is, legacy of your mother, Joan Rivers?
You know, no one would ever try, any no one in their right mind would ever try and live up to her. I mean, everyone's like, don't you want to do stand-up? You're so funny. I'm like, no, I wouldn't want to put myself in that situation where, I mean, there's enough comparisons. You know, she always said one of the things that frustrated her the most was I never got credit.
Melinda, what are we starting out with?
That's Melissa.
Who's first? Miranda.
Melissa.
Miranda.
Melissa.
Whatever.
She got all the credit and I rarely got any. And that was very frustrating to her because we were such a team and you couldn't have done what we did on the red carpet and Fashion Police without each other.
They're going to be doing the real scoop on all the fashions and our fashion reviews, as you know, and they're becoming infamous, if not famous.
It was a very special lightning in a bottle thing.
Whether on the stage or off the stage, on set or off set, what is that memory, the one that you'll never forget, the one that you go to when grief kind of creeps back in?
I remember going into my mom's hospital room and it just being such a horrible moment. And what saved me and has gotten me through it and got me through the last 8 years was nothing was left unsaid. And I'm so lucky that I knew that she loved me and that she knew I loved her.
Listen, she was never one to hold her tongue. She always had an opinion full of life. What do you think her stance would have been on cancel culture now, which is something that a lot of her fellow comedians have faced in the past?
I think she would have appreciated the conversations it has spurred. I think she would have had a big, giant, deep sigh at this point, probably an eye roll. And as she always said, making someone laugh is like giving them a mini vacation. Everybody, take I can't say it.
I can hear it.
Yes.
I can hear it.
By the way, it wouldn't be the first time one of us had said f*** on E.
Don't f***
Joe with an old whore. Yeah. Shut the f*** up, shut the f*** up.
It's like old days, yes. Do you think she would ever greenlight another go or attempt at Fashion Police?
Absolutely, 100%. I would take a swing at that too.
Ryan, I've made my list and I've checked it twice.
Oh,
did you know that Gosling means little goose? And guess who's in the mood for a little goosing? Honk, honk, honk.
Over the years, has there ever been a celebrity where you thought to yourself, ooh, I could easily see him with my mom?
She was a big Ryan Reynolds and Ryan Gosling person, and you know, that would be like fish in a barrel for her.
Ryan, guess who else is 78 and also likes it doggy style?
She would have turned 90 years young this week. How do you continue to keep her legacy alive?
She pretty much has taken care of keeping her legacy alive on her own, being such a legend. I guess the most exciting thing is I have decided to put our archives, including the famous joke catalog, at the National Comedy Center in Jonestown, New York.
What a huge announcement. In all of her years, do you think she could have ever imagined? What do you think she would have said to this big moment?
What would she say to being turning 90? She would not be happy. To her archives going to the National Comedy Center, I think she'd be thrilled.
And when I die, Melissa can sell us to some lucky, lucky comedian who will then, if there's more, have enough to keep them going for their whole life.
There's 50 plus 60 years of archives, probably even 65. We have everything from some of the first typed out pages of jokes that she wrote. We have all of her Tonight Show monologues. We have everything from E. We have, you know, every joke pretty much that she's, you know, some we've got cue cards. We have contracts. I mean, we have stuff from way back in the early 60s. So it's just really exciting. And also we've got a box set coming out with some unheard material called The Diva Rides Again. That's on pre-order now.
As we come up on this date where we're celebrating what would have been her 90th birthday, is there anything else that you would like to share, Melissa?
She loved her life. She was happy. She was truly always living her best life.
I am so happy for you, and I wish I had voted for you.
She cracks herself up.
I love when Joe cracks herself up.
I waited all... I'm wet now from laughing.